Passive optical network, or short PON, is a very cost-effective and widely used technology to provide high-speed connectivity. So far so simple, but the question is, what's up with all these different acronyms? If you want to find out more, stick around and we'll check it out. Spoiler alert, they're all different PON standards. And the first standardized PON that we had was the so-called APON, and that was back in 1998. And it was based on the asynchronous transfer mode, and that's why it was also called APON, as in asynchronous. And in this case, both the downstream and upstream was 155 Mbits per second. Only shortly after that, a revision of that APON standard was released, and at the beginning it was also called APON, but that led to quite some confusion, which is why it was quickly changed to BPON, as in broadband PON, and the downstream was then increased from 155 to 622 Mbits per second. A few years passed, and in 2003 the GPON standard was released, G as in gigabit. And the downstream was 2.5 gigabits, whereas the upstream was 1.25 gigabits per second. Now, very shortly after that, so in 2004, the EPON standard was released, E as in Ethernet. And in this case, both the downstream and the upstream was 1.25 gigabits per second. Yes, you're seeing correctly, this came later, but actually had a lower downstream than the GPON standard that came earlier. So what happened there? Well, there is a technical reason for that, because GPON actually uses the ATM, so the asynchronous transfer mode, for voice, it uses Ethernet for data, and it uses a proprietary encapsulation for video, whereas EPON uses Ethernet for all types of data. And the other difference is that GPON has an encryption only for the downstream, whereas EPON has the encryption for both down and upstream. And of course, there's the non-technical reason, and that is that GPON is an ITU standard, whereas EPON is an IEEE standard. Okay, fast forward a few years. In 2009, the 10G EPON standard was released, and as the name states, it's 10G Ethernet, so the downstream is 10 gigabits, whereas the upstream is 10 gig or 1.25 gigabit, and as it is EPON, it is an IEEE standard. Now, the ITU, of course, they were also working on the successor, and that's why shortly after, in 2010, XG-PON was released, X as in Roman number 10, and the downstream was 10G, and the upstream was 2.5 gigabits per second. Now, few years passed again, and then in 2015, NG-PON, as in next generation PON, was released, and we had both 10G upstream as well as downstream. Now, the important thing to note with the next generation PON is that the overall network throughput is actually 40 gigabits per second, and that was achieved by using a combination of timing and wavelength division multiplexing, or short TWDM. And shortly after that, so actually in 2016, XGS-PON was released, and S as in symmetrical, so symmetrical down and upstream, because XG-PON had 10G downstream and 2.5 upstream, whereas XGS-PON has 10G up and downstream. Now, we've got both of these now, both with 10G downstream and upstream, so and both ITU standards. So what's the difference? Well, the difference is, in this case, the application, because XGS-PON is the more cost-effective solution. So in other words, XGS-PON is more used in the area where cost is a very big deciding factor, whereas NG-PON, with that higher aggregated throughput, is actually then used more for the high-demand applications, so high-bandwidth demand applications. There is one more standard that has already been released, and that is the 50G-PON, which was released in 2021. But I didn't include it in this list because at the moment it's more these that are deployed, widely deployed. But of course, in the future, that most likely will change at some point. So, I hope you enjoyed this video and that you learned something. If so, please leave a comment. Of course, remember to follow our channel so you get your regular dose of brain snack. Until then, see you in one of the next videos. Bye-bye.